The dangerous water shortage out west that is only going to get worse. Barack Obama and I were talking about it over a dozen years ago. Where do we go from here? It's coming up next on Jim on History.
It's Jim on History.
Jim on History. It's Jim on History.
Jim on History with Jim Heath.
So I grew up out west in Arizona, and I remember vividly as a kid in the 1970s, the local weather people on the local news started a campaign in coordination with the state of Arizona called Beat the Peak. And basically it was a water conservation effort in the 1970s. Get rid of your green grass, replace it with desert motif, rocks and desert things, cactus. Never water your lawn if you're going to keep a lawn until after 7 o'clock at night, 8 o'clock at night when the sun went down, these type of things. So water management and conservation is nothing new to those of us who have lived out west, but the severe water shortage at Lake Mead and Hoover Dam, that has recently really been a wake-up call for particularly residents of Nevada, California, and here in Arizona. The before and after pictures of Hoover Dam are just startling. Hoover Dam now at the lowest level of water in its history. Of course, it was built back in the 1930s. Lake Mead put into place in the 1930s to take care of the water needs of big cities, including Los Angeles and San Diego and Phoenix and Tucson and Las Vegas. And now there is a severe water shortage, which is going to, starting in 2022, really affect agriculture primarily, and then individual consumers if it continues to drop. I remember a conversation that I had with Senator Obama. My career has took me to the South for a number of years, where I anchored the news in Myrtle Beach, South Carolina. And I remember talking with then Senator Obama back in 2007 about growing up out west, and particularly going to Vegas all the time as a kid. And it just amazed me a dozen years ago that Vegas was booming, that so many people were moving to Vegas, where there is not a natural water supply to take care of the population. I mean, Nevada and Las Vegas in particular gets about, 90% of its water from Lake Mead. And the natural aquifers that Las Vegas is sitting on, I mean, there are too many people to draw from it, quite frankly. So a dozen years ago, before our formal interview in South Carolina, Barack Obama and I spoke for about a minute about the upcoming and ongoing water crisis out west. Take a look. You know, we used to drive there to pick up my grandparents.
You move ready when you're
all right. 20 miles to get to Vegas, and it was nothing. Now it's all suburbs, and there's no water there. So I don't know what you're telling the folks in Nevada, but I'm sure that's one of the questions.
They're bringing it in from the rural areas up north, and so the rural folks up north, the ranchers, and all these folks are complaining. Mm. And there's a real intrastate conflict there. Gotcha. Between water resources.
Well, when they signed that CAP a million years ago, Nevada was just a blip, so they really got kind of screwed from the very beginning.
Yeah.
Senator, good to see you.
Great to see you. Thank you.
So that was our conversation about Nevada, with Barack Obama mentioning there that water already in 2007 was being piped in and trucked in from northern Nevada down to the southern part of the state, Las Vegas, where the majority of the population is at. That's long before the recent concerns of Lake Mead. And the drought, the ongoing drought, climate change, man-made, fact, just is what it is, whether we address it or not. But, I mean, the drought is going to continue. It's at its worst now, and there is no sign that the West is going to have significant relief, which means water challenges are going to be around maybe for the rest of our lifetimes.
Amazing to see it up close.
For more than eight decades, the Hoover Dam has relied on water from Nevada's Lake Mead to cover up its backside. But now at age 85, it finds itself uncomfortably exposed. Much of the water the dam is supposed to be holding back is gone.
This is like a different world.
Pat Mulroy is the former head of the Southern Nevada Water Authority. She says Lake Mead, the nation's largest reservoir, is on track to soon hit its lowest level ever recorded. This part of the Colorado River system is a crucial water supply for Las Vegas, Phoenix, and Southern California. It makes the vast agricultural land of the desert Southwest possible.
this landscape screams problems to me. I mean, just look at the bathtub rings. To me, that is an enormous wake-up call.
Lake Mead is at just 37% of its capacity. Wow. It hasn't been full since back in 2000 when the water came right up to the top of Hoover Dam. This is what it looks like now.
Since 2000, Lake Mead has dropped 130 feet. That's hard to imagine, but picture a 13-story building on top of my head, and way up there, that's where the water used to be. So you and I talked here back in 2014.
And we did.
At that time, I asked you, how critical a point are we at?
It's a pretty critical point.
If you look at 30 feet lower now, what point are we at?
We're at a tipping point. It's an existential issue for Arizona, for California, for Nevada. It is just that simple.
For the first time ever, the federal government is expected to declare a water shortage on the lower Colorado River later this summer. That will force automatic cuts to the water supply for Nevada and Arizona starting in 2022. Homeowners have higher priority and at first won't feel the pain as badly as farmers.
If we don't have irrigation water, we can't farm.
Dan Thielander is a second-generation family farmer in Arizona's Pinal County. The water to grow his corn and alfalfa fields comes from Lake Mead.
So next year, we're going to get about 25% less water. Means we're going to have to fallow or not plant 25% of our land.
In 2023, Thielander and other farmers in this part of Arizona are expected to lose nearly all of their water from Lake Mead. So they're rushing to dig wells to pump groundwater to try to save their farms.
The future here, honestly, I hate to say it, but it's pretty cloudy.
This is an engineering marvel for sure.
Back at Hoover Dam, facility manager Mark Cook has his own concerns. Lake Mead has dropped so much that it's cut the dam's hydropower output by nearly 25%.
So these are generating the electricity, these things?
Yep, exactly.
He wanted to show us the new turbine blades they just installed.
So right below us right here is that brand new turbine.
Designed to keep the power flowing efficiently at rapidly dropping lake levels. At some point, the dam could stop producing electricity altogether.
Our previous number was at elevation 1050, and now we've lowered that number to 950. So we bought ourselves 100 feet.
All those islands were underwater?
Completely submerged.
Pat Mulroy says a rapidly retreating reservoir may be the new normal, and the millions of people who rely on this water supply will have to quickly learn to live with less of it.
We don't change unless we absolutely have to. Well, when you look out at this lake, I think that moment of it's absolutely necessary has arrived.
For CBS This Morning, Ben Tracy, Lake Mead, Nevada.
Wow. Generally, I'm an optimist here on Jim on History. We watch a segment and we talk about what we can learn from history, improve our country and our communities. I'm not very optimistic about this. There's just no sign that climate change is going away. There's no sign that the drought out west is going to miraculously get better. In fact, there's every indication that water levels are going to continue to drop. Farmers, those in agriculture, are going to notice it first. 2022 is going to be a rough year for them. Those plants that are not planted means less food, which means costs are going to go up, not just in the West, but all across the country. The drought is going to continue. And then consumers, you and I who are living out West, are going to begin to have to tighten our belts when it comes to water use. Arizona already could be looking at losing enough water in 2022 that would serve a million people. Think of that. That's just the beginning. Lack of water for 1 million people that the rest of us are going to have to absorb, that all of us are going to have to absorb as the water shortage reality sets in. We will continue to cover this because I think it will be ongoing in the years ahead. And hopefully the West can find out a way to recycle water. Maybe make ocean water more available. I don't know what the science is on there. We'll do other Jim on Histories in the future about some of the techniques that might have to be implemented. But right now, the West is going dry. Lake Mead is going dry. And people in part of our country are going to have to learn to conserve water and conserve it quickly. That's it for Jim on History today. If you haven't subscribed to the channel, please do so. Ring the bell. Give this video a like. Also comment down below. Love to hear from you. Until we see each other again, take care, everybody.
So remember to subscribe to the Jim Heath channel and hit that like button. Thank you for watching.